Hello. The last of the third lecture. And today you will see a surprise. The Rattrap Pedro. He has sprung a surprise for us. And that is this one. Ends like this, written with friendship and high regard, Captain Von Style. And this is the story of a peddler and captain. In that way, he got power to clear himself. And let's continue. So in the last section, we have some two or three questions. Who is the real Santa Claus of this story? And that is, we know, the Iron Master's daughter, Etla Williamson, Miss Etla Williamson. She is the real Santa Claus of this Christmas. And then you also saw that what was he doing? What was the peddler doing? Was sleeping. So he made no trouble. He created no trouble for them, isn't it? And family all together, they were very happy because they had especially Miss Edla, because she could feed a poor wretch on the Christmas Eve. So that's what we saw. The next morning, the Iron Master and his daughter got up in good season. Good season was early, to go to the early Christmas service. The guests were still asleep. They did not disturb him. They are okay, let him sleep. Sleeping before meals and after meals. When at about 10 o'clock, they drove back from the church. The young girl sat, hung her head, and more dejectedly than usual. Dejected, depressed. At church she had learned the reason for the dejected feeling. At church she had learned that one of the old crofters of the ironworks had been robbed by a man who went around selling rat trap. That was a surprise, so sure. And the father said, "Yes, that was a fine fellow. You let into the house," said her father. "I only wonder how many silver spoons are left in the cupboard by this time." Because that is the pattern of that person, habit of that person, to steal. So there are silver spoons. It's a manor house. So they have silver. How many will be left? The wagon had hardly stopped at the front. The wagon, that is the wagon in which they traveled to the church. They went to the church. The wagon had hardly stopped at the front steps when the Iron Master asked the valet whether the stranger was still there. So he was anxious. How many things he might have robbed him or stolen and gone away. He added that he had heard at church that the man was a thief. So anxious. Even before the wagon stopped, he got out and asked, "What about that man? Has he gone?" "Oh my God, he was a thief." The valet answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. So, in sweeping contrast to what he was thinking, the Iron Master was thinking, he gets an answer. He did not take anything at all. And further, on the contrary, he had left behind a little package which Miss Williamson was to be kind enough to... A little package which Miss Williamson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas present. It's not that he did not take anything, but he left a present, it was a Christmas present. The young girl opened the package, which was so hardly, so badly done. It was not well packed. No. Half of it was exposed. The condenser exposed, so badly done up that the condense came out into view at once. She gave a little cry of joy. Oh! Cry of joy. She found a small rattrap. That's the thing. And in it lay three wrinkled 10 crore notes. Wrinkled. It's like, as you know, your shirt before ironing, it will be wrinkled, you know, like that. Wrinkled. Folded and folded and folded. With many folds. Called notes. But that was not all. How many surprises that morning? He did not steal anything. He left behind a present. And in the present, the present was a rat trap and 3 10-kroner notes. Fourth surprise. Fifth one comes, a letter. And what is the letter? In the rat trap also lay a letter. Rather in large jagged characters. Jagged, see jagged. Jagged means rough. And with the rough and the endings are, see, something like this again. Ragged characters. If you say captain, will be writing like this. Captain. You cannot see that. You cannot understand it. Sometimes you find when you for some verification purposes, you in a particular column you will get a ragged, jagged characters to verify whether you are the person who is operating that particular account in the net, when you take net, you know. When you are doing business with the internet, you will find this jagged characters. They are rough. At the same, the endings are not clear. Very difficult sometimes to find out this jagged characters. Then what happened? And what was the letter? Honored noble miss. Since you have been so nice to me all day long, as if I was a captain, I want to be nice to you. So if you are nice to a person, you other can be nice to you. But this cannot be applied in this case. Why? Because the old man on the roadside was so nice to him. And the rattrap peddler, what did he do? Stupid fellow, he stole his 10 crore notes. All what he had to support his life. So always this is not correct. This may not be correct always. For the always this may not happen. But most of the time it will happen. And then what did he say? I want to be nice to you. In return, he says, as if I was a real captain. I want to be nice to you in return. As if I was a real captain. For I do not want you to be embarrassed at this Christmas season by a thief. But you can give back the money to the old man on the roadside who has the money pouch hanging on the window frame as a bait for the poor one. As a bait for the poor one. There is no logic behind that. Who told you to go and rob him? It is not a bait. It is the bear, he gives his money. So you cannot justify that, what he says. Hey, still, at least second time he did not do the same. First time he did, but second time he is very gentle and he is repenting, he is very sad and he is returning that money. He said the pouch hanging on the window frame as a bait for the poor one priest. Then he said, the rat trap is a Christmas present from a rat. That's very important. Because now he is sorry for what he has done. He has accepted his mistake. He says, I am a rat. I am not a human being. I am a subhuman creature because of my behavior, my character, my dealings with others. Now I don't want that. I am going to change. There is going to be a sea change in me because of you. That's a rat who could have been caught in this world's rat. Two meanings are there. One is that already I was caught by a bait, the roadside old man's window. That's one. I myself could become a victim of the rat traps. Of the traps or the baits offered by the world. The other meaning is that I could have been caught by the police. Understand? One is I voluntarily would have been a victim of a bait. Second is the law enforcing authorities might have caught me. For example, there is a threat that he would be taken or the sheriff would be called or he would be taken to the city. In both ways it could happen. I said. So, this world's rat trap, if he had not been raised to a captain, because in that way he had power to clear himself. The rat trap with friendship and hierarchy. So, there is what is called a recognition, a point of recognition. And this point of recognition is arrived not because of any sermon or preaching or advice, but because of an action. You can advise anybody. The easiest industry in the world to start is advising me. The easiest thing to do in this world is advising me. But showing an example, it is more powerful. That's what happened to all the great men, Mahatma Gandhi, Jesus Christ, Mother Teresa. So this, all the great men, Abraham Lincoln, you have Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela. So if you take all these leaders, the power behind them is not just talking, but action. Do as you say. Do as you preach. First you, and to me I said, first you do and then you preach. That's it. First you do. Because whenever, in my experience, I tell you, whenever I want to ask money from others for charity. We are running a charity, a group of people, we are giving food to all the way side wanderers. Means people who buy the bonds. There is an outlet that we have opened. Anybody in this part of the world, anyone who comes asking for food, will be given food. The program is called One Meal a Day. And you can see, if you pass by this part of the world, you will find a board, 6x4, big board. And it is written, have you taken at least one meal today? Question mark. So, if not, you come here and you will be given food coupon free of cost. You can get into the next hotel and have a square meal. So that is it. But you know, when we started, we were a group of us sitting around discussing. Then I said, we should collect money from others. Tell you very frankly, I said, no, you should not. First, let us put. Don't think I am boasting, this is something that is happening. Happening here. So we ran the project started in 2008. Now it is 2020, 12 years. Halfway through we started, because the volume increased, and so we started asking people, please help us, and we are getting here. But the first thing is, first you do. I'm just sharing my experience, that's all. So if you do, and then, you know, you might know, it's a very famous story. Mother, when the Mahatma Gandhi is saying that my son has the habit of eating shakar means sugar, one form of sugar, please advise him. Then Gandhiji said, you go and come back after 1 week. So again, the mother came. The boy went on eating shakar, sugar. Then came back, called the boy, Gandhiji called the boy and said, my son, don't do this. This will harm me. Even I have diabetes, such things can happen, so don't eat. Now you go. I bless you. Then the mother asked, Guruji, last week when I came, you would have said this. Then Gandhiji said, you see, little lady, I had the habit of eating sugar. First I should stop that, only then I have got the moral right to advise your son. And that's why I said, come next week. So action first, then words after. Action first, talk after that. Don't give talks. No question of giving talks. First you do. That's it. As teachers, very often we like to advise people. Then before advising, you should see that you do it first. That is the thing. And so, here you have a story of a story written with friendship and high regard. Captain von Steyr. That means the peddler has now become a captain, a decent man. All this because of the kindness. Repeatedly he is getting it. One from the old man on the roadside, the other now here in the Iron Master's hall. At the same time, he also met with persons like Iron Master, who was very rough and tough, you were seeing. But still this young lady, very fond of serving, looking at the wretches, she could effect a conversion in him. So, a conversion. That is through actions. Now questions, there are not many words here. Questions, what you can see. What are the four surprises you can see? First surprise, he did not steal anything. He went away. Second surprise, he left a package. And third surprise, he left a Christmas present. Fourth surprise, he wrote a letter. Fifth surprise, you can say, he requested them to return the money to that old man on the roadside. He supported by a cow. All surprises. And sixth surprise, half a dozen, he has changed himself. There's a sea change effected in this man. That's because of the kindness, softness, the love, the concern that a young lady had towards a poor rat-trap peddler. I can also do such, effect such changes in the society. think it out. Bye. Have a nice day. Enjoy your life. Hope that you have enjoyed my classes. That is, I humbly request you to share it with other people so that this others also can get benefit out of my classes. Bye. Have a nice day. Enjoy yourself. We will again meet with another lesson in the near future. Till then, bye.